Books, welcome to English 9 Online, and we are ready to dive back into To Kill a Mockingbird, which I'm really, really excited about. Chances are you've seen a few emails come through. Sorry, that's just been me kind of messing around a little bit on Google Classroom, figuring out what the best way is for us to navigate this. So in a moment, I'm going to shrink this box, and that way you can kind of see me in the top right corner, and then I'll show you kind of what Google Classroom looks like. Before I do that, though, please know that you are going to see a variety of things up on Google Classroom. You are not going to be expected to do all of them. I try to give you as many ways possible to kind of capture what it is that you've been working on, how you've been navigating To Kill a Mockingbird. So you are not expected to do every single assignment. And so hopefully this video will go ahead and kind of help you figure out what it is that you need to do. So there I go, shrink myself down. All right, so you should be able to see Google Classroom right now, either fourth hour or fifth hour. Remember, whatever class that you're signed up in is absolutely fine. Don't worry if it doesn't correspond with what you're in this semester. If it was last semester, no big deal. So you see three things up here. The one that you totally need is this one. And you'll notice that there's kind of a book here with a bookmark. It says new material. That's kind of your go-to one-stop shop. These other two things you might use to earn some points this week, or you may not. There's a chance that you don't end up touching either of these, and I promise to explain how to figure out what works best for you here in just a moment. So I said this is your one-stop shop, posted materials. This is what you need for this week. So let's take a look at everything that's in here. Looks like a lot. I promise it's not nearly as daunting as it looks. There are multiple chapters in here from the graphic novel version. So that's why it looks like there's a lot of documents. Again, some of you are going to use that this week. Some of you are just going to read out of the regular book, and you don't need those at all, so you'll ignore those. Same with the audio that we have down here. If you like to listen along as you read, fantastic. The audio's here for you. If you prefer not to, then you won't even use that at all. What you do need is this guy up here, which is going to outline kind of the points, and then by the end of the week, you need to submit your points using this guy. And I promise to show you that in just a moment. So let's take a look at what I mean by kind of collecting your points for this week. So let's click on this. This is technically week 5 of our quarantine. It's April 13th through the 17th. So I'm gonna go ahead and click right on that. So here's the document that also came out to you in an email. Your goal here is to earn 25 total points. And we'll kind of break that down here in just a moment. But the big goal here, and don't get caught up in points as terms of, in terms of what's actually going into the grade book. We still have some question marks about that. This is all about making sure that we are doing the work that we would normally be doing, staying sharp. And so really that gives us two goals for how to do that. One of our big two goals is gonna be to finish To Kill a Mockingbird. It is a classic. It is the one piece that you really need to hang on to from English 9. It's a great cultural piece. It's also the most challenging of the bunch, and so it sets you up the best for English 10. The other task is going to be what you see down here, a literary analysis. It's a certain type of essay. We've actually been doing a lot of literary analysis type work already, and I'll walk you through how to actually write that, and you'll have the chance to do it and get feedback. And that way, when you enter English 10, you are good to go, and you know exactly what your English 10 teacher is talking about. Certainly, they'll do a little bit of review, knowing that this is a little unconventional, but having these skills is going to be so incredibly important. So our two big goals, finish Mockingbird, write a literary analysis. That way we are good to go with those. So how do you earn those 25 points? Again, there's gonna be a lot of things on here that you're not even going to need to do. There's 40 some possible points on here. You need to get 25 of them. So let's go ahead and take a look. So you get 5 points for every chapter that you just straight up read out of the book. So if you read chapters 13, 14, 15, 16, every chapter that I am asking you to read this week, you're at 20 of your 25 points already. Nice and easy. So if you're a big reader, if you're ready to take some of that on, you're gonna knock out 20 of your 25 points just by reading. However, I also know that that's a big ask for some of you to read 4 chapters this week. So you'll also notice that in the 3-point category, I've given you some graphic novel opportunities. You can check out chapters 13, 14, and 16 in the graphic novel. So if you want to skip actually reading and just use those for context, you're more than welcome to. You'll notice I didn't give you chapter 15, though. You need to read at least one chapter directly out of the book. And chapter 15 is the one that I'm going to absolutely ask you to do for this week. There's so many good things that go on there. But again, if you just straight up read, you're going to get 20 out of those 25 points. Let's say you did graphic novel for three of the four chapters. That's 3, 6, 9. And then you read chapter 15. Well, now you're at 14 points already. You're off, you're cruising, you're in really good shape. So how else can you earn some points in addition to actually reading and navigating the chapters? Two conversations that you can join us for Google Meet, one on Thursday, one on Friday. Joining one of those will earn you 4 points. And so if you read all of the chapters and you join a conversation, you're at 24 of the 25 points already. Not bad. If you are unable to do that, or if you are leaning heavier on the graphic novel this week, which is absolutely okay, then there are a couple other ways that you can chip away at that 25 points, such as going back and revisiting chapter 12, which we read together, where the kids go with Calpurnia to church. Go back and revisit that in the graphic novel. 2 points. Nice. In addition, if you're someone who maybe doesn't love the Google Meets or is a little hesitant to try that, you can also just do just some standard questions. I created a document for you. Hop back over here really quickly. If we go back to your main page, chapter questions right here. Couple questions for each chapter that you can go ahead and fill out. One's been created for each of you, so you don't have to be worrying about kind of commenting on top of each other's. This is your individual one. So for example, Joey, if he decides to do this, he'll just open that up and he'll type his answers right in here. Or if Joey decides that he's reading all the chapters and is joining discussions and doesn't want to answer any of these, then he'll leave this document blank, and that's absolutely fine. All right. Hop back really quickly here. So if we go back then to kind of our main sheet and how we get our points and all of those things, there we go. We can read right out of the book. We can read from the graphic novel. You can join Google Meets. Those are your big points. And then you can chip away by revisiting old chapter, answering some questions. And again, you could do that just for chapter 13 if you wanted to. 2 points for every chapter. So if you answered the questions for 13, 14, 15, and 16, well, that's 8 points. And last but not least, at the end of the week, if you would like to, there's just a one question for 1 point, and it's what'd you notice and what are you left wondering after you navigated this week's worth of reading? So again, there are a lot of points available. You need to earn 25 of those. So we kind of gave some examples as we were talking, but maybe you're sitting there saying, Mr. Pruder, like that was a little bit fast. One, pause, rewind me. That's kind of nice. You don't get to do that in class. Or I also gave you some examples down here. Now, some of these have a lot going on, a lot of little things. Or we also talked about this example down here, where if you read all the chapters out of the book, there's really not much for you to do. So let's take a look at this example and work our way up. So if you read all the chapters out of the book, 13, 14, 15, 16, okay, 5 points apiece, you're at 20 points. Let's say you also went back, visited chapter 12 in the graphic novel, bonus two, you're at 22. You know you need to get 3 more points. Well, you decide that you really want to talk about some stuff because chapter 15 was really good. You join one of the Google Meets. You're at 26 points. Got a bonus one. Fantastic. Or if you're not reading all the chapters out of the book, I also gave you a few other options of how to get there, right? Maybe you went back, you did chapter 12, you checked out some of the graphic novel stuff. That's how you navigated your reading. So you got to 16 points. You know you need 9 more to go. So you did a Google Meet. You answered a couple chapter questions and that exit ticket. Fantastic. Or one of the really broken down ones, you navigated the graphic novel, 15 out of the book, got you to 18. And then you took a look here, Google Meet, answered one question, exit ticket. That'll put you in really good shape. So you've got a lot of different ways that you can navigate this to get to your 25 points. How do you fill me on what you've done? Well, when you head back here in your materials, oh, and there's your exit ticket, by the way, 1 point. When you head back here, you'll just submit your points right in here. You get a nice, easy Google form that looks something like this, asks for your name, and it says, what chapters did you read right out of the book? Let's say you only did 15. No big deal. That's how you got 5 points. Well, that means that you better have done 13, 14, and 16. I'll change those to check boxes. Sorry about that. What additional work did you complete this week? Let's say you joined us on Thursday for the Google Meet, you did an exit ticket. And then if there's anything else I need to know, such as, ooh, maybe you did chapter questions, you did questions for chapter 13 only, submit, and then I'll be able to go through and find your points. So, nice, easy way to fill out that form. All right. So once again, this looks like a lot going on, but it's just so you can access that graphic novel, just so you can access the audio, and it just tries to put everything in one spot for you. All right. Now, let's be honest. This is a big learning curve for you. It's a learning curve for me. You did not sign up to take my class online, and in truth, I didn't really sign up to give it online. So we're going to work our way through it. I'm hoping this is clear. I'm hoping this is a way that you can navigate it in a way that makes sense to you, in a time manner that makes sense to you. But if not, please let me know. We're going to give it a go this week. We're relying heavily on the graphic novel or having the option for that, because I'm asking you to kind of do all that pre-work of 13 to 16. That way next week we get to the trial finally. That's chapter 17, 18, 19, 20, 21, the really, really good stuff. And so once we get there, like the book gets rolling again. So hopefully to help us kind of work our way through the slower part, we can kind of rely heavily on that that graphic novel. All right. So again, any questions, comments, concerns, shoot me an email, shoot me a message to remind, and we will work through this together. Excited to hear your thoughts. Hope to see you up on one of our Google Meets. I'll send you invites for that once it gets a little bit closer. And I'm excited to see your thoughts in the terms of an exit ticket or answering questions, whatever you're most comfortable with for showing your knowledge. Folks, have a great week. I'm excited to catch up with you and get back at it with To Kill a Mockingbird. Take care.